What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRiderYT.com and I'm back once again with another SQL tutorial. And today we will learn how to create new user account using Enterprise Manager. In the previous two tutorials, I have explained how to create user account using SQL Create User statement and SQL Developer Graphic User Interface tool. If you haven't watched those tutorials, then find the link in the description box. And this will be the last tutorial in how to create new user account series. So let's start. The simplest way to launch the Oracle Enterprise Manager is through your Start menu. Just go to your Start menu and then All Program and find your Oracle folder here. Here is mine. Click and expand it. In this folder, select Database Control ORCL. ORCL is MySID. In your case, it may be different or you may have more than one database control options here. This is because Oracle Enterprise Manager is a web-based management tool for individual database. This means that Oracle Engine creates and configures unique Enterprise Manager for each database. Now click and launch it. Now you will get this login page. Here you have to log on to your database as sys user with sysdb privileges. So in username, write sys, and in password, write your sys user password. And the most important, choose sysdb in connect as field. Now click login. And here we are. As you can see that we are connected to the database which has SID ORCL. Now just click and go to this server tab. Here from security section, choose users. This will take you to your user space and here you can see all the users of your database and their settings. To create a new user, just click this create user button. I highly suggest you to watch my previous videos on how to create user in Oracle database. There I have explained in detail each of these options which are on the screen. For better understanding of the concept, you must watch my previous two videos on how to create user. Link is in the description box. Okay. Here, specify the name of your user in name field. This time I will choose Superman because I have already created user by the name of Iron Man and Batman. Now profile. By default we have two profile. First is default and second is monitoring profile. But we are creating a default user, thus I will select default profile here. Next is authentication. As I have explained in my tutorial 37 that we have three ways of authentication. First is password. Second is external, third is global. When you set the authentication on global, then all the logins or authentication information gets saved into a central Oracle security server. In the case of external, the authentication is handled by external services such as your operating system. And lastly, the password. When the authentication is set on password, then you have to supply the password every time you want to log on to your database using the user. I am going to use password here. Thus, I will enter the password and click confirm password. If you want to prompt your user to change the password on its first login attempt, then check this checkbox here. Let's move ahead to the table spaces. Here, we will choose the default and temporary table spaces. Click this torch button corresponding to the default table space. This will open up a window where you can search and select the table space. You are free to choose any table space as default table space except the undo and the temp table space. I will choose example here. Similarly, you can choose the temporary table space. Now, mind here, you can only select those table space as temporary table space which are temporary in nature or created as temporary. In my case, I have only one temporary table space by the name of temp. So I will choose the temp as my temporary table space. Now let's move on the account status. If you want to lock the account, then choose this lock options, otherwise let it be unlocked. Now the next tab is roles. As I mentioned in my last video that roles are group of privileges. As you can see, there is already a role assigned to our user, which is connect. Actually, as I told you guys before in my previous tutorial that every newly created user needs a mandatory system privilege, which is create session, to get connect with the database. Without this privilege, user will not be able to log on to the database. I have also shown you the demonstration in my video tutorial 37. This connect role is a default role created by Oracle while installation, and Oracle has assigned the create session system privilege to it. Thus, you can either grant create session system privilege separately or just grant this connect role to your user. Both will work the same. If you want to grant this role with admin option, then check this checkbox. Otherwise, let it be on default. Now, let's jump over to the next tab, which is system privileges. Here in this tab, you can grant system privileges to your user. Say you want to grant create table to your user. For that, click this edit list button. This will show you the list of all the available system privileges for your user. Here from this list, choose the create table. Here it is. Now click this move button. You can also choose this move all button to grant all these privileges to your user. But I don't think any wise DBA will want to take this risk. or you can use these remove buttons to remove the granted privileges from this list. When you are done, click on this OK. Here you can see the list of all the granted privileges. Check this admin option checkbox if you want your user to grant this privilege to some other users or role. Now move on to the next step, which is object privileges. An object privilege is the right to perform a particular action on an object or to access another user's object. I'll be doing a separate video on user privileges where I will explain you the concept in detail. But for the time being, let it be like this, as I don't want to grant any object privilege to my user. So let's move on to the next step, which is quotas. Quota clause can help you in specifying the maximum amount of space which the user can allocate in a table space. I have used example as my default table space, thus will assign 50 MB quota on this table space. For that, click on this drop down list. Here we have three options. First is none. Select this if you don't want to assign any space to your user on this table space. Second is unlimited. As name suggests, you can select this option if you want to allot unlimited space to your user on this table space. And the third one is value. Using this option, you can specify your own desirable size. Such as in our case, we want to assign 50 MB quota, thus we will select this option. And then we will specify 50 in this text box of value column. You can also select the units like kilobyte or megabytes here. Let it be on megabyte as we want to allot 50 megabyte size. Next step is consumer group privileges. We will not be doing anything to this step, even not in the next step also, because we use this step when we design resource plan for database. Resource management, which in itself a very big topic and impossible to cover in the time frame of this SQL tutorial. It seems we have done all the necessary settings to create a new user account. If you want to see the SQL query corresponding to all the settings which you have done so far, then click this Show SQL button. Here is your SQL query. Come back to our main window. And here, click OK. And your user has been created. Search your username in this list. Here is our user Superman. Click on the name of your user to see the settings. Like this, here you can click this edit button if you want to edit your user. Everything is done. Our new user has been created. That's the last way or the last tutorial on how to create a new user account in Oracle database. Hope you enjoyed watching. Please like my videos as your likes keep me motivated for doing more such video. You can also write a comment and I'll be very happy if you share my video and help me in sharing knowledge with more and more people. Yes, very important, don't forget to subscribe and be the first one to watch my video. I upload SQL tutorial every week. Thanks, we'll see you soon. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.